in the present time of Satan ruling in the planet Earth, with the devils and their human children, even the children of God was led astray and was deceived, because many are the children of the devils than the children of God in this temporary kingdom of evils. Majority decision. The evil prevailed. You will be lucky to find a few good men, if there is even one. In Romans chapter 2, verse 20-29, and chapter 3, verse 1-18, a man is not a Jew if he is only one outwardly, nor is circumcision merely outward and physical. No, a man is Jew if he is one inwardly, and circumcision is circumcision of the heart, by the Spirit, not by the written code. Such a man's praise is not from men, but from God. What advantage then is there in being a Jew, or what value is there in circumcision? Much in every way. First of all, they have been entrusted with the very words of God. What if some did not have faith? Will the lack of faith nullify God's faithfulness? Not at all. Let God be true and every man a liar, as it is written, so that you may be proved right when you speak and prevail when you judge. But if our unrighteousness brings out God's righteousness more clearly, what shall we say? That God is unjust and bringing his wrath on us? I'm using a human argument. Certainly not. If that were so, how could God judge the world? Someone might argue, if my falsehood enhances God's truthfulness and so increases his glory, why am I still condemned as a sinner? Why not say, as we are being slanderously reported as saying, and as some claim that we say, let us do evil that good may result, their condemnation is deserved. What shall we conclude then? Are we any better? Not at all. We have already made the charges that Jews and Gentiles alike are all under sin. As it is written, there is no one righteous, not even one. There is no one who understands, no one who seeks God. All have turned away. They have together become worthless. There is no one who does good, not even one. Their throats are open graves. Their tongues practice deceit. The poison of vipers is on their lips. Their mouths are full of cursing and bitterness. Their feet are swift to shed blood. Ruin and misery mark their ways, and the way of the peace they do not know. There is no fear of God before their eyes. In 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 1-2, the Spirit clearly says that in later times, some will abandon the faith and follow deceiving spirits and things taught by demons. Such teachings comes through hypocritical liars, whose consciences have been seared as with a hot iron. And in Timothy chapter 3, verse 1-9, but mark this, there will be terrible times in the last days. Today is the last days. People will be lovers of themselves, lovers of money, boastful, proud, abusive, disobedient to their parents, ungrateful, unholy, without love, unforgiving, slanderous, without self-control, brutal, not lovers of the good, treacherous, rash, conceited, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God, having a form of godliness but denying its power, have nothing to do with them. They are the kind who worm their way into homes and gain control over weak-willed women, who are loaded down with sins and are swayed by all kinds of evil desires, always learning but never able to acknowledge the truth. Just as James and Jambres opposes Moses, so also this man opposes the truth. Men of depraved minds, who as far as the faith is concerned, are rejected. But they will not get very far, because as in the case of those men, their folly will be clear to everyone. That is why I am here talking to you at this moment, to continuously reveal the truth and reveal the secret of darkness, to let you know the truth, to set you free from the grasp of evil, to be able to learn the truth of the Word of God. First, you need to put aside everything you have learned from the beginning, from the schools of men and from all the religions you have heard and follows. You need to become like a little child who knew nothing, like an empty city. There are too much trash human educational teaching and false religious belief recorded in your brain. It needs to be replaced with a real wisdom from God, the highest form of knowledge. In other words, you need a complete re-education. You need to start all over again, like a little child. A little child knew nothing from the beginning. A little child listened and obeyed humbly the teacher without any complaint. Instead, a little child is always eager to learn many new things with faith. In Matthew 18:1-7, at that time, the disciples came to Jesus and asked, "Who is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven?" He called a little child and had him stand among them. And he said, "I tell you the truth, unless you change and become like little children, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. Therefore, whoever humbles himself like this child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. And whoever welcomes a little child like this in my name welcomes me. But if anyone causes one of these little ones who believe in me to sin, it will be better for him to have a large millstone hung around his neck and to be drowned in the depths of the sea. Woe to the world because of the things that cause people to sin. Such things must come, but woe to the men through whom they come. If God is willing and allowed me to do, I'll say to you the following, that is, if you trust the word of God, how to seek God's kingdom and his righteousness, that it will follow with everything you need, the right way to be prosperous, peaceful, happy, and satisfied. With religious saves, how many will be saved in the Gentiles on the end time, and how many in the Israelite nation? Yeshua, Messiah's millennial reign, who will be the judges in the great white throne judgment, the kingdom of God and the kingdom of heavens. How many heavens are there and who is going there? How many hells are there and who is going there? The good angels and the evil angels. Creation versus evolution. Is horn really the sign of evil? Is the cross really the sign of good? Are the present pastors and priests authorized to solicit and receive tithes? What is water baptism? What religious organization the early prophets and apostles belongs to? The recipe for assured good health. Faith and works. Sabbath versus Sunday, the Ten Commandments of love, which commandments are nailed to the cross, carrying your own cross, the real meaning of the way, who is real brother, sister, parents, relatives, the Almighty God, the Holy Spirit, Yeshua, Messiah, or Jesus Christ, the true meaning of 666, sin and punishment, sin of idolatry, sin of blasphemy, the great deceiver, how good is he? Am I really born again now? What is love to God? What kind of life are waiting for the children of God and the children of the devil after Jesus' millennial reign? Wait for the things in the coming episode.